This is back in the Windows 95 days. Still runs. It's essentially a sequence generator. It's not, what you're hearing is just square waves. But it has four 40 position slide switches that allow it to create patterns of notes that take millions or billions of years to repeat. It has a 40-bit shift register, 40 bits, an exclusive OR computes the next bit coming into the circuit from the bottom bit and the four sliders on the right, WXYZ. And the sliders on the left are what actually create the melody. So from that shift register, you can derive four voltages or numbers, and you add those together, 1, 2, 4, 8, and you get a note. It's about a 2-octave range. And it's programmed, I think, for a major scale. So it's not, I think. It doesn't do, it's not hard, it's not chromatic. But the sliders determine how it computes the next note, more or less. And 40 to the power of 8.
Quick, somebody.
40 to the 8. There are that many switch combinations.
Yeah.
Now, they're not all distinct patterns, but pretty much they are. Nothing. But it's always going to sound like this. This is all it does. It's just one voice.
Yeah.
You can change the tempo, the volume.
Yeah.
And that's pretty much it.
Running into a filter, right? Or...
Oh, yeah. It's been used on stage as a sequencer. It was designed by Marvin Minsky with Edward Friedkin of Carnegie Mellon, I think, around 1970. And there is a patent. It's patented, and the patent has a good deal of information, but you kind of have to know what you're doing to find your way through it.
What is it called?
And it has some expandability. The connectors on the bottom allow these to be chained, so you can use the same cloth for multiple. And there was also another box, the same size and shape, which had lights in it. So you could get colors out of the box from the notes. And there's a couple of other, there's like audio input and output, a keyboard. I don't know what else it's doing. I've never seen these. This is a bit of history. There were only a few hundred of these made, and they really weren't built as performance instruments. They're not really stage worthy, and I think very few of them are still even as good as this one. This actually makes noise, but it could definitely use cleaning. So if you open it up and clean the circuits that would help. Because those 40 position slide switches are not really switches, they're just sliders across PC copper. You can sort of imagine what they do. Nobody makes a 40-position slide switch, right? 8 is about the maximum. But clearly, if you clean those traces, you probably get better connections.
Does it have a name?
Triadex Muse.
Triadex Muse.
Triadex is the company. Muse is the only thing they ever did. Cool. The company was Boston-based somewhere around here. Newton. Minsky and friends incorporated, rented factory space, built a few hundred of these things, and advertised it in like popular electronics, which is where I found out. And when they were new, they were $400 or $500. And in 1970, that's a lot of money. So I wanted one. But I've never seen, it's the first time I've actually seen one in person. So I made a simulator instead.
I got it for about $150. I saw it in a catalog, I got in the mail. Yeah.
So
they were trying to get rid of it, I guess.
When did you buy it?
Around the mid-70s.
Wow. So you got it much prices than you.
Yeah.
Because you stuck it in the last 6 months. And you've held on to it ever since?
Yes. Yeah.
And taking good care of that.
Yeah.
Anyway, this is a piece of history. You will probably never see another one. Very few. There's somebody that might be in this one.
Yeah,
there's a synth guy. There's lots and lots of things. It's probably up to that.
It's making a funny sound. Making a funny sound.
That's good.
Yeah.
Alex, would you like to show us what you built and brought today?
Yeah, sure. It's